friends, welcome here. And in this lesson, we're in chapter 14 of the Blossoms of the Savannah, and we are almost done with the book. And as usual, we are going to analyze the themes and the stylistic devices. Be ready to learn. Chapter 14 is a very long and interesting chapter, and I'm going to start by giving you a brief summary of the chapter. In this chapter, Oloisudori had invited Mama Milanoi and Olekaelo to the home of his sixth wife as a sign of appreciating the hospitality offered to him and his friends. And the main aim of Oloisudori inviting the Kaelos is for them to see and appreciate his kingdom. And he was very sure after seeing the palatial home that was being built for Isian, it will make it easier for them to convince her to marry him. And Olekaelo is greatly flattered when Oloisudori compared Resian to the legendary beautiful brown girl who traversed the songs of the four generations in the past 50 years. Oloisudori also compared Resian to the famous English lady whose love besotted Lord Ngata. And he even thought he and Lord Ngata belonged to the same, to birds of the same feather. To make sure that he's not rejected by Resian like Lord Ngata was rejected by his lady, he thought to beautify his home and in order to appease Resian and win her love. And he's even willing to allow Resian to join the Egerton University as soon as she is settled. After the visit, Oloisudori takes Mama Milanoi and Olekaelo to a restaurant for a cup of tea. And in the process, they discuss how the issue of Resian or how Resian will be dealt with. In the same chapter, Olekaelo had a dream that Resian has conceded to Oloisudori's proposal. He was happy and he thought the dream will become a reality. Also, Resian and Tayo planned to return Oloisudori's gift, which are returned by Resian the day that Oloisudori visited their home. This is when Resian learned that Oloisudori had paid dowry for her. For that reason, Resian goes to shop in Nasila to talk to him about joining the Egerton University. And this is when she learns that Olekaelo had taken dowry from Oloisudori. After learning that, Resian lands to Nasila River, and the chapter ends with Olaringoi telling Resian that he'll take her to Emakerere's place. And now we move to the themes in the chapter. The first theme is the theme of determination on page 204. Resian is determined not to be married by Oloisudori, and she tells him she can only be married to him over her dead body. She also tells her father she'd rather die than get married to the monster. Theme number two is greed and materialism. And Olekaelo is both greed and materialistic. Page 188, Olekaelo remembered that Oloisudori had told him that he has a friend who will be interested in his daughter Tayo. He hoped that he'll come soon and he will be like him, who will hand him a briefcase full of notes worth half a million without even mentioning what he has offered. That is the theme of fear. On this page, both Tayo and Resian fears Oloisudori. Tayo says she's not sure if she's able to face him alone because she cannot trust him if they are left in the room alone. On the other hand, Resian says she fears him because he is like a monster. When she thinks about him, she squirms in her shoes with fear. Betrayal on page 208 to 209. Olekaelo betrays his daughter Resian by selling her off to Oloisudori. And he tells Resian that he has taken dowry from Oloisudori and she is to be his wife whether she likes it or not. And he even goes to an extent of slapping Resian. Last theme is conflict. We have conflict between Olekaelo and Resian. When Resian went to the shop to confront his father about his intention to marry her to Oloisudori, Olekaelo ends up slapping Resian twice for talking back at him. This conflict makes Rosian to run away, and she landed at the hands of Olaringoi, who betrayed her later. And now we're on the stylistic devices, and the first one is the use of a song. On page 186, we have the song about the brown girl who caused the Moran to traverse the Suswa. We have flashback on page 188, and we have to Olekailo recalled what his father used to tell him. That was, it was only a girl or a woman who goes to bed, who went to bed poor and woke up rich the next day. On page 193, on seeing the gate of the Egerton University, Olekailo recalled angrily Resian talking to him foolishly about the joining the Egerton University, and it was such kind of talk that made Olekailo to hate Resian with passion. It's a dream on page 195. Olekailo had a dream that Resian has consented to Oluisudori's proposal. Although they were astonished, they were relieved to live with the guilt of having forced their daughter to get married. Lastly, we have vivid description. On page 201, Oluisudori is described as wearing a pair of white trousers, white leather shoes, short-sleeved, white-flowered, collarless shirt, golden chain, golden bracelet, and golden wristwatch. And I think Oluisudori is my favorite character. I like him because of his confidence. That is the end of our lesson today. Thank you for watching. In case you have any question, shoot me on the comment section. And today I'm also going to teach you one French phrase, and that is bonsoir. And it means good afternoon. See you next time on chapter 15. Bye bye.